Marco, I'm going to present the work that we are doing in order to design the system that enables us to supervise and control the operations of the digital infrastructure. This demonstrator was done in collaboration with our colleagues in Lancaster University. So, trying to visualize what the digital infrastructure is, so we have this figure in which in the bottom, we observe that there are a number of physical elements, physical network elements. On top of them, we have virtual functions that are deployed and that ultimately enable the provision of the services to the customers. So these physical devices in the bottom, they are deploying in some control or uncontrolled spaces. And eventually, they will enable us to collect number of data about the performance, about the condition, about the environment, and then the idea that we should be able to use that data in order to make different decisions about management or control of the infrastructure. And in order to do so, we are designing a system that is based on agents that are monitoring and controlling, taking care of each one of these specific devices. So this demonstrator is going to present part of that system in operation. The idea is that we have deployed together with our colleagues in Lancaster a network with some realistic conditions, and these agents are assigned or mapped to all the devices or the switches that are part of this network, in this case, the blue squares in the left. So the agents are going to take care of those devices. They are going to monitor the traffic, monitor the performance, and they are going to trigger actions that enable these devices to, for example, activate or remove flows from their configuration. In addition, since we also want to include perspectives that enable us to see or to control or to make decisions based on the physical condition of the devices, we are simulating here a device, a physical device that deteriorates and that provides a number of sensor readings, which in turn we use in order to make predictions about the state of the device. For example, we can take the temperature, we can take the CPU usage, or we can take different other features or characteristics of the device and try to make a prediction about when the asset is going to fail. And using that information, the agents are going to trigger different actions in the network infrastructure or actions, for example, related to notifying the users. So in order to communicate or to interface with the network infrastructure itself, we are using ONOS, so we are using the APIs provided by ONOS in order to read, for example, information about the topology, the traffic, or the intents that are enabled within the infrastructure. And we are also using that interface in order to trigger actions for rerouting when a given asset, for example, is going to fail. In addition, we are also integrating with some chatbot in order to provide the user an interface or a way to send commands to the agents. And so the agents are able also to notify and to communicate with the users. In this case, the engineers or the operators using that chatbot. Additionally, the agents are also able to push information to some dashboard platform, and so any engineer is able also to monitor, for example, the condition of the assets and the predictions that the agents are doing based on the information that they are collecting. This work is particularly based on all the behavior or the dynamics of the agents, rather than in the ONOS or the network operating system itself. which is more part of the work of the other colleagues in the project. So the way that these agents are designed is enable us to change or to adapt, customize the behavior of these agents on runtime. So essentially, we designed a number of general behaviors that the agents are able to pick or to use on demand on runtime, and we are able to trigger customized image of these agents that are able to collect or to be assigned to any particular device or network element. You have more details about how the architecture, the approach that we are following in the paper that which reference I have left here in the bottom. And of course, this was the internal way that the agents were designed, but also there are also different possibilities in terms of the communication, of the links, the interactions that the agents may have among them. So the idea of the design is that these interactions are also possible, so it's not specific of the agent. They are not coupled in a particular interaction mode, but they are able to use the information that they know about other agents in the system in order to make decisions about, for example, which routes to take or which actions to take in every particular time. So without further ado, let's have a look to the demonstrator. We are ready now to run the demo. So in the bottom of the screen, we have the terminal where we have the command to trigger the agents, so let's trigger the agents now. So we can see now that they are start connecting with the ONOS APIs and then receive information about the devices available. In the top, what we have is the typical ONOS interface with the blue boxes representing the switches and the lines representing the different connections between these switches. So we are going to focus particularly in this device, which is essentially the one that is going to fail. We see there is traffic flowing, which is represented by the green lines. And so while the agents finish to start up, later on we are going to see what are the interfaces that the agents have with the user, particularly the dashboards, as we can see here. So we see the condition of the different assets in our network, and we have the chat where we can activate the capability to start the predictive maintenance. So in the background, what the agents are going to do, they are going to start running prognosis algorithms that will allow them to predict when a given asset, in particular the S9, is going to fail. So once the agents detect that, they are going to ask us to reroute, or to they ask us for confirmation to reroute the traffic out of that asset in order to perform maintenance. So let's wait for the message. We should receive a message from the agents once they have detected that the traffic is of the asset is going to fail. Okay, so we have the message now. So it's we need just to confirm that we require maintenance for this. For this asset, so we just need to type it yes, and then the agents automatically they are going to communicate with ONOS and reroute the traffic. Now we got confirmation, this is the message we just received, that the traffic has been rerouted, and we start to see that happening here in the network visualization. So we now see that the flows have changed, the green color has changed from these links to the ones in the bottom. So now we have rerouted the traffic because we wanted to do maintenance, and we got the confirmation in the chat. So that's it. Many thanks for your attention, and if you have further questions, please contact us in the details. We leave the details in the description of the video. Thank you very much.